Welcome to the Innovation Coffee Break. I am Thomas, and today we will see how SIL testing can benefit the development in the context of smart charging. Let's assume you are developing software for a charging application, regardless of whether it is for an electric vehicle or the supply equipment. In order to test your software, you have different options. Of course, you can test the software in a real world with an actual vehicle and supply equipment. Another option would be to connect your device to a simulator that represents either the electric car or the supply equipment. This is called hardware-in-the-loop testing. However, wouldn't it be even more convenient to test the software as soon as possible without the necessity of any hardware? This would allow to save cost and time because of parallel simulation is possible. Also, the simulation could run faster or slower than real time, and you could execute the simulation step by step for debugging purposes. These are the benefits of software-in-the-loop testing. For today's presentation, let's assume you are developing an onboard charger for an electric vehicle. To test your software that is running on a real ECU without the hardware components, we first construct a virtual ECU. Now you can put the software components you want to test on that virtual ECU. For the SIL environment, further components need to be added which are dependent on your hardware. The abstraction layer you are transferring is up to you. You can only test your application layer without the consistency of your user code, or you can add basic software components if you, for example, want to test the communication as well. When the virtual ECU is constructed, you can run it on a simulation platform like VIOS from dSPACE and connect it to a virtual simulation of an EVSE. This gives you the software-in-the-loop environment and provides the benefits mentioned earlier. Here, I only want to highlight one benefit in particular. You can perform conformance tests in an early SIL development, but more later. First, let's see how this looks in practice. At first, let's take a look at the simulation environment VIOS. We can see both models of the EV and EVSE, so it's up to you if you want to test your software components of the electric vehicle and need the supply equipment as a counterpart, or vice versa. Further, we can observe a third part in this environment, the interface model, which is needed and explained later. We can also inspect that both the EV and EVSE are connected via CAN, and due to the usage of dSPACE software chain, especially the bus manager, we can run this as a rest bus simulation. VIOS itself is running in the background. To be able to see what is happening while in the simulation is being executed, we switch over to Control Desk. Here we can see Control Desk is connected to our VIOS simulation. VIOS also allows to set the simulation time. Currently it's set to 1, but we want to run it as fast as possible, therefore we set this here to 0. Afterwards we can start the simulation. When the simulation has loaded, we can choose the charging standard. Today we are particularly interested in the CHAdeMO standard. Therefore we have to choose CHAdeMO in the EVSE side and also on the EV side. Now we can execute the charging procedure. For that we have switched over to the interface model and plug the electrical vehicle virtually to the EVSE side. We can now observe a change in the state of the EV. To actually start the charging procedure, we have to go over to the layout of the EVSE side and start the charging procedure by pressing this button. We can immediately see that the states of the EVSE side have changed and also of the EV. Now our EV is connected to our EVSE. We can see this connection and the CAN messages that flow over the bus on the already implemented CAN monitor. Control Desk not only allows you to view the states and the CAN messages, but also allows you to manipulate certain aspects while running. Let's assume we are interested what happens when we, for example, manipulate the D1 switch. For that, we have to switch over to the EVSE configuration layout. Here we can see the D1 switch and its current state, that it is closed. We can choose whether we want it to be open or closed. We choose to be it open. By pressing this activation, we can override the state, and now it's open, and we can examine what changes in the state of the EV side. Of course, as a developer, you don't always want to perform every test yourself. You are more interested into automated testing. This is covered by Automation Desk. In Automation Desk, we already have predefined conformance tests that can easily be executed. Those conformance tests can be viewed here on the left-hand side. Let's choose an easy test, for example, test case 4. And I've already opened test case 4 here in the middle, and we can view what test case 4 actually does. We can run test case 4 by selecting test case 4 and press, for example, this execution button. Also, F5 is valid. Since we are not interested in the name, we let it as it is and just press the OK button. Down here, we can see that the test has already passed. And when everything is finished, we can view the report. By opening the report, we can see what the test is about, and we can see that switch D1 was turned off. It's the same switch that we used before, now as automated. But let's head over to Automation Desk and run another test. For example, test case 64. When we execute this test, we see that some parts of the test have passed, but one has failed. What actually happened, we can view in the report. Here we can see which part of the test has passed and which one has failed. To actually debug it, we can also scroll more down. Here we can see the plots that are related for this test case. Every state that is related to this test case is plotted here, and we can use this for debug purposes to figure out why our EV have failed the test. We have seen how the dSPACE tools can help you develop your onboard charging system in an easy to use and intuitive way. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us. Our experts can help you to set up your SIL environment for better testing and development. Thank you for listening and goodbye.